second days and stuff?
It was a joke, sir.
And being lost in here is why you stay grounded and stay focused on reality.
Oh, I am well aware of reality.
Do something like that.
No, I just, well, I was at the business before I'm old.
Trist?
Come on, we'll never grow up.
Just call it like it is.
Well, the one good thing is that there's almost zero chance that we'll be living in your name and I shall run.
A relief.
Roblox won't work, so I'm not going to sit down and
play it.
Somewhere I could go inside.
Okay, so wait a minute.
you're telling me that they both went into a building or a business called Roadside?
Yes, that's right. Honestly, people, I told you that.
Come on. And then if they zombies, they said on their horse. Poor, poor.
Looks like it's near here.
No, that's 50 miles away from where you were spent time. What about Roadside Auto Service?
That's not even in town.
What about this one? It's off the main road. Just away. Roadside Storage?
Well, map it to Rodina's pickup point west and see if it's near Pike.
It's on the track, but it's going to be the numbers.
Are you seeing a car or are you going to talk?
No, it's one son.
Okay, good.
Wait a minute. Oh, you can't go. Is that there? This is a police matter, Sharon.
Well, the only reason you know about this is because of me. I'm not going to sit and wait by the phone. I've already done that. Besides, if you won't take me with you, I have the address. I can drive there myself.
All right, let's go.
Jeez, God, don't know if it's too late.
Chelsea texted and said that Hillary's talking about that on the show.
Good, get the public involved.
Yeah, let's see if they're still in that second show comes back on.
Yeah, hopefully not focusing on Lee's involvement in the sex ring.
Well, it's Hillary. How long can she go before she starts talking about something salacious?
You like it, Lyle? That's okay. Two can play in this game.
And welcome back. Now, we are going to be revisiting a very Jordan Wilde and all of his secret identity. Now I asked for your help that day. Who is Jordan Wilde really? Is that even his real name? And why did he need all of those fake IDs?
Well, since you're saying all of this, I'm guessing that you have recent news on the matter.
Well, I was flooded with tips once that story aired. Unfortunately, a lot of them turned out to be exercises, creative writing. But just now, one of my producers was able to verify a lead.
We are going to live with a viewer who is on the phone, Connie Wood. Connie, are you there?
Hello. Yes, I'm here.
Well, welcome, Connie, to the Hillary Hour. Now, I know that this is probably not easy for you, but according to what you told my producers, you initially reached out to our show because you recognized one of the aliases used by Mr. Y, correct?
Yes, he was just a pretender back then.
Now, I heard that you two met on vacation.
It was very romantic, exotic.
I'm sure that you're a single woman. You're well off. And may I say, more mature?
I'm a widow. My husband passed a few years ago.
I'm so sorry to hear that, honey. And you were probably very lonely and vulnerable during that time. Knowing Justin, I'm sure that he was very attentive and charming. Hmm?
He treated me with so much affection and respect. He said the age difference didn't bother him one bit. One doesn't care about numbers. That's what he said. It was a whirlwind. And soon, he proposed.
But I'm sure that something went terribly wrong the day that you two were supposed to become man and wife.
At the courthouse, a woman showed up, said she was his wife. But it's probably more accurate to call her his accomplice. It was all just a scheme to blackmail me, but I didn't know that then. I
producer has that loaded into our system. A photo that was supposed to be a happy wedding picture is now evidence of a con. Do you have the Wait, so Connie, this is a photo from your wedding day.
Where they have a few spots on
the board. And it's completely flagrant. Photos can be altered. Connie, you heard my call just there.
Now, I'm not a technical person, but I assure you, that photograph is very real. That woman, just a so-called wife, she or she ruined me. There was a tabloid, the local news, anyone and everyone to say I was trying to steal her husband.
And what was that been happening? Let me guess. Money?
Yes, it was so humiliating. I paid the money, wanted to forget any of it ever happened.
And then you found out you were the main victim.
Just the other day, after you posted those phony IDs, I met a woman in a society event. She had the same experience with the same couple.
They scammed you, and they scammed her. And you two probably weren't the only ones. Praying on women who are just looking for love and want. You and your heart were taken advantage of. I'm sorry that this happened to you, Connie. But I want to thank you for coming forward. Because together we can make sure that this doesn't happen to anyone else. My babies, now you heard the buzz here first. Jordan Wild, con artist extraordinaire. But together, we can make sure he never breaks another heart or bank account ever again. We'll be right back.
You bitch!
Hey, you know, it might not have been Chelsea. I mean, the picture was pretty fuzzy. It could have been anybody.
Well, we knew Chelsea had a past. We also knew she knew Jordan in New York City.
But nothing about her.
No, nothing.
Wow.
Now the whole world knows. How much $5 is the press looking for a comment?
You didn't answer? I told you to do all the steps.
And I told you to save the press. Why did you keep those fake IDs?